Hey guys, welcome back to the show. I'm your host, Jamie Zwier, and today we are talking about a topic that I have been hearing about, the current state of events, and with being quarantined, we are trying to stay as healthy as possible, keep our immune system as high as possible, and what I've been hearing or seeing on the news or just hearing from other individuals in the health and wellness field are ways to keep your immune system high, which is essential, right? We need to keep our immune system high, not just now, but all the time. And I hope that what we're kind of realizing through this is that we need to stay well, we need to stay healthy, not just for aesthetic reasons, not just for weight loss reasons, but that we don't get sick so that we can stay strong and just be as preventative as possible. So anyway, I've been seeing and hearing on the news these ideas of keeping your immune system high, which is great, right? But what I always immediately think about is, okay, that's well and good and all. Your tips are amazing. I know that I should be eating more vegetables. I know that I should be having zinc. I know that I should be, you know, keeping my vitamin C high. I know I should be exercising. I know I should be sleeping 8 hours and drinking water and doing all these things, right? But how? How am I fitting this into my lifestyle? How am I coming from a lifestyle where that may be the furthest thing from my current reality because, you know, I'm busy, because I have kids, because I have a hectic schedule, because I'm stressed, or I'm trying to take care of my parents and make sure they're doing well, or you fill in the blank, right? There's just so much going on that, yeah, duh, we know we should be sleeping well, drinking all this water, exercising, but when we're suddenly homeschooling and, you know, trying to work, maybe deal with the lack of work, working from home, just with this new situation that we're all, that is upon us, we're trying to figure out, okay, how, and not only right now, but in general, like even outside of this current pandemic, like, okay, I know that I should be eating healthy foods. I know that I should working out daily and doing X, Y, and Z to stay well, but you know, maybe I've tried before and it just doesn't ever work for me. Or maybe I did find a program that worked for me and it's just so time consuming, or I go to the store and it's expensive, or I have to come home and I have to prep all this food. And so it can be overwhelming or frustrating when we hear this information and we know what we should be doing, yet we have the current lifestyle that we are living and we aim to make changes, but it's just not happening for us. So that is what I aim to do. I aim to solve that problem as to how you're going to improve your immune system, keep yourself healthy, fit in exercise, fit in drinking enough water, make sure we're getting sleep. That's my goal, to help you do that in a very simple, easy, affordable way that's going to work for you and your family. And I also wanted to point out, because on a podcast that I was just listening to, they mentioned that people who are either eat junk food or are overweight or are just unhealthy or who are diet hoppers, who just start and stop a program. And I think that there's this misconception, and this is what this person was mentioning, that they lack discipline, right? And it's just not fair to say you just lack discipline. You need more discipline. You need to work harder. You need to try harder. You need to just push, push, push. And it's not really that. I don't believe that's the problem. I think that there is so much conflicting information out there right now. There's so much, you know, there's so many fad diets. There's just so much right now out there. And also coupled with the fact that there's such basic and outdated information that we've been taught in schools about how to live a healthy life. And also just a simple fact of understanding that we know what is healthy, pretty much, right? We know an apple is healthy for us and a donut is not going to be healthy for us, right? And generally speaking. And we know why we should be eating healthy, and we know why it's not great to eat unhealthy foods. But there's this disconnect between the foods that we should be eating and then the foods we shouldn't be eating, meaning that we want the foods that taste unhealthy. That's why they're around, because they taste delicious, because they're convenient, because they're easy, because they're sweet. And we know that we should be eating other things, the healthier options. So how do we make the healthy foods taste like our favorite unhealthy treats, really? And so we're going to be talking about this a little bit more. And I also wanted to mention that it's not anyone's fault. We've just been, this information, so this lack of understanding, this lack of information, this overwhelming, confusing, these tips that are out there right now, gets passed down from generation to generation. So without interjecting new, easy, simple, affordable, enjoyable techniques and recipes and processes into the household, into our lifestyle, then it's not going to pass down to the next generation. So there's just this perpetual, continuous cycle of kind of just not knowing and not understanding. I mean, it probably wasn't until I was 17 or 18 that I knew that, oh, pancakes don't come out of a box. Like, you can make pancakes from scratch. And then not only that, but there's plenty of healthy swaps that you can make, and you can enjoy pancakes in a much more nutrient-dense way. So it's one of my core beliefs that eating well is not only beneficial for those reasons, but it's also a huge form of self-care and self-respect, which is also something we want to really focus on right now. I believe that there's nothing greater that you can do for yourself than eat well. And if you're curious about, like, okay, well, what is healthy food, or what is this food that you're talking about, we're going to briefly review that right now. But I also have other episodes of this podcast available where I go into more detail about that. But there's nothing greater that you can do for your health and your self-care and well-being than eating well. For example, if you're trying to, you know, we talk about weight loss, which obviously healthy eating is going to be beneficial for. But let's say you're also like an esthetician, or you focus on skincare or skin wellness. Guess what? All the products in the world are not going to help you unless you are fueling your body properly and feeding it proper nutrition. Same thing with anti-aging, or you have a high energy job, or you have a job where you really need to be in focus, then eating well is going to be the essential part of that. You know, no matter how many supplements or coffee are going to benefit you, like, eating a well-balanced, whole food, nutritious diet is going. And I promise you, it is not going to be a tasteless experience, an expensive experience, an overwhelming experience, because I know how that feels when you end up spending a boatload on a new program. You end up feeling restricted and exhausted and depleted, and you just can't wait until you can just have a bowl of ice cream again. And I aim to really show you how you can fit all this into your busy schedule, your family schedule, your, maybe you have some picky eaters in your home, into your budget. I aim to simplify healthy eating for busy families. So I'm going to review some things that you can start doing today that can help you bridge that gap between knowing we should be eating the healthy foods but wanting the unhealthy food, and how to make small swaps so that we can achieve that goal. All right, so my first point here is to start to blur the black and white lines between indulging and not indulging, or dieting and not dieting. I briefly touched upon intentionally indulging and unintentionally indulging in the last podcast episode, and if you want to go back and listen to that, I recommend it. But also today I wanted to just mention that it does not have to be this all or nothing thinking that typically goes on. We're either in these phases of I'm eating healthy or I'm not eating healthy, and this can ebb and flow according to the year, according to the month, according to the week, according to the day, like, oh, this was a good day, or this is a bad day. And it kind of affects the next day. We're like, I ate like crap yesterday. What's the point? I might as well eat like crap again. I've ruined my quote-unquote diet, right? And we need to start blurring these black and white lines between dieting and not dieting, and or eating healthy and eating unhealthy. We want to make small baby steps to get to where we want to go. And the ultimate goal is just making progress. We just want to make small bits of progress every single day. And progress feels amazing. It's not really about achieving the goal that feels great. It's about making progress towards that goal. And I'm sure you can think back and relate to a situation where you were building up and you were making strides towards achieving your goal. And then when you achieve your goal, that wasn't necessarily the best part. Like, that felt great. But a lot of times when we achieve our goal, we're like, okay, great. Like, when's the next goal? Or, okay, like, I lost X amount of weight. Well, I can still lose more. That's not the satisfying part. The satisfying part is making the progress towards the goal and who we're really becoming in that process. We're proud of ourselves. We feel good about ourselves. And that is going to be key. This is also why I'm not a fan of weighing ourselves, because when you weigh yourself, you are allowing the progress to solely be affected on the number on the scale. When in reality, you know that you're doing everything you should be doing. You're feeling good about yourself. You're making progress. And the number on the scale does not dictate your overall success. All right, so point one here, blurring the black and white lines, kind of bleeds into the other points that we're talking about. So I will touch upon this point again as we move through the other points. All right, so my second tip here is to go back to basics. I am a firm believer. I love simplicity. I believe that simple is better, and we need to go back to basics when it comes to trying to stay healthier. It is not about the next fad diet or, you know, the next keto trend or whatever it is. It's going to be about going back to basics. And what I mean by that is going back to whole foods, you know, fruits, veggies, nuts, seeds, grains, dairy, meats. These foods are things that are going to be most beneficial. They're foods in their whole food form. You know, it's always a goal to have whole food ingredients. And there is a way to go about this. You can go about this in a more expensive way, or you can absolutely go about this in a very inexpensive way. For example, you can pick up a zucchini, which is a whole food ingredient, and you can buy it, you know, a whole zucchini, which might cost you 75 cents to maybe $1.50. And then you can also buy zoodles, which are spiralized zucchini noodles, maybe in the fresh section, or maybe they're frozen. And so you can buy one or the other. And this is, I think, why a lot of people assume that being healthy is expensive, because we see things like this and we see, oh, it's a package of spiralized zucchini is like $8. I'm not buying that. But in reality, you can easily purchase a zucchini, purchase a spiralizer that might cost you $5, $10, which is an investment you can use over and over again. And also, I always joke that, you know, after I say, you know, go back to basics and eat these fruits and veggies and nuts, seeds, and grains, you come home after you go grocery shopping for these ingredients and you see, okay, well, I have a bag of apples, I have a zucchini, I have some broccoli, I have some chicken, I have some milk. Now what the heck am I supposed to make, right? And that's really what I do. I provide meal plans, I provide grocery lists, I do cooking demonstrations. There's a free Facebook group associated with this podcast where I really aim to show you how you can maybe make spiralized zucchini on your own, or make it into a really delicious dish that is not just a plain zucchini that you have to eat like dry or sauteed. Like, it's not, you know, there's easy, fun ways that you can turn these whole food ingredients into really delicious recipes that are going to support your immune system and keep you well. I mean, these whole foods are things that are preservative free. They don't have a lot of added ingredients, and these are foods that are most beneficial for your immune system. All right, so on to tip number three, which is all about crowding out. And when I say this, what I mean is when we immediately think of being healthy, or okay, great, like when I have to have zucchini and apples and all this stuff, it sounds very restrictive or not very indulgent. And I want you to know that you can still have your favorite things. Again, we're talking about a 0 to 25 mentality. This is not all or nothing, meaning you can still have your favorite foods. I mean, that's what is going to make this a long-term lifestyle. Instead of saying no more bagels, no more ice cream, no more chips, no more, you know, sugary treats that you love, that's not going to be sustainable, because it's only so long until you can have that stuff again, right? Because we are human. We go to birthday parties, we want cake, we enjoy wine night and Taco Tuesdays. It's going to be about how we can start to crowd out our existing unhealthy foods that we know we should not be eating, and how we can start to crowd, especially if this tip is going to be especially important if you're coming from a lifestyle that is more unhealthy than healthy, meaning you really enjoy your junk food, you're having a hard time giving them up, you grew up on the stuff, you love the stuff, it's really all you know, you just don't want to give it up cold turkey. So for example, let's say you're someone who goes to Dunkin' Donuts in the morning and you get a bagel with cream cheese, you get a large coffee with extra cream, extra sugar, you know, lunch, it's another eating out, you might be having pizza, it's really not beneficial, you're spending more money eating out, you're consuming a lot of processed sugar foods. So I would not say you cannot eat out anymore, because that is very far from your current reality. What I might say to you is, let's start crowding out some of the unhealthy meals. So for example, let's say you're getting that bagel with cream cheese. In my work, I talk a lot about, yes, eating whole foods, but also creating a balanced meal. And if you're just eating a very carbohydrate-laden meal, for like a bagel and maybe with butter, maybe with cream cheese, you're not getting a well-rounded meal. So what I would say, instead of saying, hey, don't have that bagel with cream cheese, I would say, hey, how about on your bagel and cream cheese, you get some lettuce and tomato added to it. Maybe you get a piece of protein added to it. Maybe you get an egg with it. Maybe you get an egg on the side. And so right there, you're adding more nutrition to your meal. You're making it more well-rounded, more balanced, thus making it healthier for you. Because when you just have a bagel, you're going to be hungrier sooner. You're not going to be fully nourished. You might feel a little bit sleepy. And the same thing that goes with the coffee, you know, a coffee with extra cream and extra sugar is obviously not the best thing for you. So instead of saying cut out the sugar, no more, like a traditional diet would, I would say, hey, how about you just get regular cream and regular sugar? Or maybe you just start to eliminate the sugar. Maybe you still say extra cream and less sugar, right? And then just doing that for a week or 2 weeks or a month. And then slowly then saying, okay, well, instead of this bagel today, I'm going to try this rice again because I'm really enjoying these extra added nutrients and vitamins from even this small bit of tomato and lettuce that I'm getting. Or I'm feeling a little bit better and a little more focused and more full since I'm getting some added fiber or protein from my meal and a little bit less foggy head fogginess because I'm having a little less sugar. You know, that is going to, of course, boost your immune system. It's going to help you feel better. And it's going to help you start to bridge that gap from where you might be to where you want to go. All right. My fourth tip is make healthy swaps. So this is kind of like tip number three where I say crowd out, but this is how you're still going to be able to enjoy your favorite foods in a healthier way. So remember when I said, first of all, I didn't know box pancakes could come, you can make them from scratch, but there's also a way where you can enjoy the same kind of food like pancakes, but in a nutrient-dense way. Because I don't like to have pancakes. A pancake is similar to having that bagel. It's just going to be high carbohydrates. I'm probably going to have syrup and butter on it. It's going to be high sugar. I'm just not going to feel great after having it. I'm going to be sleepy. It's just kind of not worth it for me. Of course, if I want to have it, there is a time and a place to have these. But what I recommend is making a healthier swap. So one of my favorite ways to have pancakes nowadays is to blend up a half a cup of oats, a banana, and an egg together. And you blend it up in a blender and it makes like a pancake batter. These almost the same exact thing that you would get mixing flour and oil and milk together into a pancake batter. You would get the same feel. You'll cook in a frying pan and make pancakes. Now, is it going to taste 100% exactly like your other pancakes? No. But over time, you start to not even miss the other stuff. You start to feel better. You're getting a banana in there. You're getting some fiber. You're getting some whole grains. You're getting some protein from the egg. And you just feel good about yourself, right? You're making that progress like we talked about earlier. And again, like this is just blurring those black and white lines because you're not having your favorite thing. You're still having it just in a healthier way. And like I just mentioned, if you just want regular pancakes, then go ahead and have it. There's no saying no to your favorite foods because that is not living life. It's about finding a nice balance. And my fifth and final point here is to find some sort of accountability. Maybe it's an accountability buddy that you found online and you're connecting via Zoom. Maybe it's a family member that you are asking to check in with you every day at 9 a.m. or 9 p.m. to see if you completed your goal. Maybe it's a challenge that you and your family are doing right now to make healthier meals together. Maybe it's, you know, a friend that you're taking strolls with. Maybe it's just someone that you're making a phone call with to check in and say, hey, you know, this was my goal for the week. What's your goal for the week? And how do we do? You know, these small little things can help. And like I mentioned before, I have the free Facebook group where you can join. You can pop over. The link to join will be in the show notes. I also have my membership access, Oh How Healthy Insiders, where you can join. We do accountability calls every single week where we check in with one another. I see how you're doing and how I can support you. But ultimately, you know, just make those little itty-bitty baby steps. You can do this. It does not have to be an overwhelming, stressful experience that feels so restrictive and like every other thing that you've tried before. When you get knocked down, just get right back up. That's the only thing that's ever going to matter. No matter how many times you tried before, no matter how many times you tried and failed, the only thing that matters is when you get back up. So the same thing, this also goes for when you feel like, oh, I messed up on this meal again. There is no messing up. No, it's just brushing yourself off and then getting back onto the bandwagon and getting back up and trying again. One of my little sayings that I came up with is there's no falling off the bandwagon. There's just getting off and partying every once in a while. So I hope that helps you. I hope that you understand that you do not have to live a restrictive lifestyle in order to get results, in order to boost your immune system, in order to get weight loss results, in order to achieve whatever kind of health goal you're trying to achieve. It can be so much simpler than you've ever imagined. And I'm here to support you. So I hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please feel free to leave me a rating review, and I would love to see your feedback, and I will catch you all in the next episode. All right, thank you guys. Bye.